Time to hit those highlights, and we'll start with our game of the week in South Charleston. The Black Eagles hosted the undefeated Huntington Highlanders, and both squads came out the gates strong in this one. Huntington with first possession, Highlanders in Black Eagle territory, and a nice pass to Noah Wainick gets them the first down right there. Now lined up inside the 10, Gavin Locho with a little trickery and flick to Amari Felder. Felder's able to swing it around and in for the first score of this game, now 7-0 Huntington. But it wouldn't stay zero for long. SC's turn to drive, and the big bus, Mondrell Dean, is able to handle this one and get big gains on back-to-back downs for the Black Eagles. Here he is again. And then Dean is able to do it himself as he spots a hole inside that 5-yard line and gets in there for SC's first score of the game. Now, this was a close one at half, but Huntington racked up 42 points in the second half alone to win this big. The final 52-21, the Highlanders roll on to 9-0.
Well, we had a wild second half of tonight's Scott Poker game. Dots looking to stay undefeated in this one. We'll start with the QB, Jordan Wolf. On the sneak, makes it a 26-21 Poca lead in the fourth quarter. Well, the defense ruled in the second half. Skyhawks Matt Fry's pass is tipped and picked by the Dots. Campbell Meeks, big turnover for Poca, but they wouldn't go anywhere. Wolf dropped back to pass, swallowed by the Skyhawks defense. Christian Cooper, the first one there. Scott with a chance to take the lead after a controversial intentional grounding and an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. Had like 4th and 40 here. Malachi Woodard Jones, the exclamation point on this one. Poca holds on 26-21.
Wow, a close one right now there. Now in Beckley, Beckley traveled to the Hill tonight to face George Washington, and a familiar face on the sidelines. Cleveland Browns wide receiver Ryan Switzer was there tonight, and this one stayed tied at 7 for most of the first half. Then towards the end of the second quarter, a handoff to Keegan Sack gets a huge gain for the Patriots, putting them right at that goal line. Abe Fenwick to Sack again here. He spots a lane in the middle and fights his way through for G-Dub's second score of the game. Now they led there 14-7, but it wouldn't last long with less than a minute left in the half. The Flying Eagles sling nice it catch from the 50-yard line. Keenan Cook wide open as he runs it in to tie it up before halftime. But the Patriots would win this in the end, the final 48-35.
All right, another crazy one here. Hurricane back at home hosting Capitol. Maybe the highlight of the night here is Ismael Barrero launches up a prayer. Lucas Ripito over a defender, somehow keeps his feet in bounds. Skins up 7-0. Second quarter, it's Barrero again. This time he's intercepted by Trenton Tiggle. As Tiggle has some room to work with, that will set the Cougars up with great field position. Then it's Zion Smith. Shakes a defender, will find the pay dirt. Capitol on the board, 7-6. Second quarter, we're back with Barrero on the option. And watch this, just lays down the hammer. He gets a 15-yard penalty for looking over his fallen victim. Hurricane blows out Capitol 54-6.
Ouch. All right, here we go. Spring Valley hosted the team from up north tonight. Fairmont Senior, the Polar Bears, sitting at 500 on the season so far. We start this in the second quarter. Wolves already up 7-0. And a step back and pass to Ben Turner snags the first down for Spring Valley. And unfortunately, they couldn't score on that drive. But later in the second quarter, the Timberwolves once again with the ball here. QB Dalton Fouch looking to pass. And the ball falls right into the hands of Polar Bears' Kaysen Neely. The first half ended 7-0 Spring Valley. The Timberwolves opened it up in the second to shut out the Polar Bears tonight, the final 21-0.
We head over to Raleigh County. We start in the third quarter where Shady Spring hosting Ripley fans. They're going all at it. Shady Spring goes 3 and out to start the half. Ripley with the ball, the handoff up the middle for a decent game, but he's met by a swarm of Tigers. A few plays later, Ty Stevens rolls out. He hits Shady Springs' Gavin Davis right in the chest. That is an interception. He had himself a big night. Touchdown in the first half on a pass from Cameron Manns. Big momentum shift there as Ripley falls on the road 28-14.
And Wayne traveled to Sissonville tonight, and hey, check this out. These ladies brought their own heaters. Now that was smart. We started in the first quarter here. Sissonville with a handoff to Dylan Lucas. He breaks free, and he's gone. He gets the 6 to put the Indians on top early. It's 7-0. Wayne's turn to respond here. QB Grady sprawled in with a quick pass to Landon Wolf, and Wolf speeds it in for the TD. They go for 2 here, and it's good. Wayne up 8-7 right there, and we'll go into the second quarter. Sissonville goes back to Dylan Lucas, who caps that nice drive, and the kick was good here. Indians were up 21-8 at this point. Sissonville ended up winning it, the final 45-22.
Big win for Sissonville. Roane County on the road facing second-ranked Doddridge Bulldogs will get on the board first. Jaron Jones gets the scoring start with a two-yard run. Bulldogs up 7-0. Fast forward to the second quarter. Doddridge taking it into the air. Jones to Gabe Stewart. 27-yard pitch and catch. 14-0 Bulldogs lead. Roane, though, getting a big play here. Skyler Delk up the middle will take it to the house, though they will fall in this one. Yeah, tough atmosphere. 44-16.
All right, and in Ohio, the Ironton Fighting Tigers. Ooh, look at that.
Getting wet.
Yeah, hosted Portsmouth Trojans. Now we catch this one in the first quarter. Trojan ball here. Drew Rowe backs up, starts running lateral, looking to pass, and fires it. Check this out. High and long, and makes the connection with Donovan Carr. Carr is able to run it easily into the end zone for the first touchdown of this game. And the Trojans attempted an extra point, but it was blocked here. Check this out. Blocked by those Tigers. So it ends up being 6-0 Portsmouth. The Ironton defense did step it up in the second quarter, and Portsmouth just couldn't get past them. So they settled for a field goal. Trojans still leading here 9-0, but those would be the only points scored tonight for Portsmouth as Ironton opened it up after that. The final 36-9 Fighting Tigers.